What's up, everybody? First, good YouTube. This is Marktoon, and I really, really apologize for not uploading any video about art over some time now. I've been working on a Photoshop series tutorial based on requests from you guys, so I'm almost done with that. But before I finish that and upload, I decided to just make a little bit of an art video, not just really a full art video, but just at least a little bit of an art video, because I still get that from someone. I said I should make a cartoon, just an art with the mouse. Okay, so now I'm going to start off from the simple part, but I hope before you watch this video, and I will hope that you have a basic idea of how the pencil works. If you're making use of Photoshop, it's fine. If you're making use of Illustrator, it's fine. But right now, I'm going to be making use of Adobe Illustrator. But I really hope you have a basic idea of Illustrator and you have a basic idea of how the pencil works. And if you are good with all this stuff, then we are good to go. So right now, I'm going to start off by showing you my document setup right now. So what I have is my document setup. When I'm uploading to Instagram, I always make use of a pixel, and I set the width to 1080, and I set the height to 1350. This is what I use. It all depends on your own settings. If you want to make use of square, I recommend making use of the 3000 by 3000 pixel, because that is what I do use most times when I work with the square. Or if you're making use of the inches, you go by the 18 by 18 inches. It all depends on what you want. But for this, I'm just going to go with the 1080 by 1350. And I'm going to hit on create. Now, when it opens up, I just have a little bit of the regular tools in Illustrator. Basically, not every tool, because I just set up this system I'm using right now, so I'm basically not gonna have every tool right here. And as you can see, it's a little bit different right now. I'm not really gonna go in depth of setting this though, because what I need, I can just bring that out and I'll make use of that. So for now, what I'm going to be using is the paint tool. Okay, so I'm gonna keep this. I'll make sure I don't have the fill color, and I have only the stroke color. That's just what I'm going to be using. Then with the pen tool, which is right here, and P on your keyboard. Now let me just give you a little bit of basic idea of how the pen tool works in Illustrator now, or just in general how the pen tool works. Now come to think of it, like the words and the opposite. The opposite of black is white, right? And the opposite of white is black. Now in the pen tool, if something is not going up, it's coming down, alright? Let's just think of it that way. Now with the pen tool, your curve, right? Look at it. If you're making a curve, and if your curve is going up, right? Your mouse is coming down, just like that. Now, think of it. And if your curve is going down, your mouse is what? It's going up. If your curve is going to the right, your mouse is going to the left. And if your curve is going to the left, your mouse is going to the right. Now, have that in mind. That is just the basic way of making use of the pen tool. Just a little I can give you guys. I can't go in depth of the pen tool right now, which is going to take a long while. Maybe later on I can make that later, but for now, it's not going to be that. So what I'm going to go into file, and I'll go to place. Is Control Shift plus P, and I will go into my document, which I'm already here, and I will click on that folder, and this is what I have, and I'm just gonna click and drag to this part, and I'm gonna leave it that way. Doesn't really matter. Now I want to bring this to the middle of this. Yeah, it all depends on how you want it to be. So yeah, I really don't have most things right here, so I'm going to property and I will go to the opacity and I will drop the opacity down a little bit, just something like that, right? And I will keep that. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to lock down this layer so that this item, so that I won't be able to move this mistakenly. So I'll go to object and I'll go to lock and lock selection. That's what I'm going to do, and I'll head over to my layer part and come down to this part and create a new layer which I'll be using for my line. Then I will grab my pen tool and make sure that I have only the stroke check and only the stroke color and not the fill color. Now you might want to double click to make sure that you have the black color selected, or you can check your hex code and see if it's 000 angle here. So I'm just gonna go through this a little bit, and later on I'm just gonna work speed this up to what it's supposed to be. So right here that you have the nose, and so what you want to do, you want to click from here and drag, get into this part, and what release, then you hit on escape on your keyboard and you do the same thing right here, just like that, and you hit on escape on your keyboard. All right, so I'm just gonna speed through this, and when I'm done with the line work, I'm gonna come back and continue talking.
Just wanna be alone tonight. I just wanna take a little breather. Cause lately all we do is fight, and every time it cuts me deeper. Cause something changed, you were acting so strange, and it's taking its toll on me.
I really, 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 really like you. And want you, do you want me, do you want me too? I really, 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 really like you.
she works the nights by the water. She's gone astray, so far away from her father's daughter. She just wants a life for a baby. All on her own, no one will come. She's got to save him.
Daily struggle.
She tells him.
Tonight.
All right. Now that you're done, now that I'm done with the landmark, so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go through all this part and make sure that I have a closed part. When I mean a closed part, make sure that all the lines are attached to one place or the other so that I don't get an open space from here where I will get one error or the other why I try to merge all these stuffs together. So I'm just gonna take my time, scroll through everywhere and see what I get. See if I can get any work online, because I'm going to expand and merge all these stuffs together so that it will be really, really easy for me to paint and say, like, now right here, I'm just already done with these stuffs. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna select all this part and hit Shift plus M on my keyboard using the Shape Builder tool, and I'm gonna merge that part from there. So I'm just gonna keep that way, and I'll keep going like this line going from this line right now. You can see that. So right now, I have this open up on my second screen. Alright, so I'm just gonna quickly check out some stuff to see what I can fix right here. So right now, all this stuff, alright, which is the foods and the cloth, what I'm gonna do, like, I'm okay with the size of the line. So we'll head over to my property, and right now I have those features turned off right here. Alright, so what I'm gonna do right now, let me just quickly check if I can get all the stuff. So what I'm gonna do right now, I'll go to Windows and I'll go to Workspace. Let me just take this back because I really don't remember those steps. Just get those stuff. No, forgive me. It's just that. Right. Okay. So now this is pretty cool for me. So now with all these strokes, I'll go up here, select the strokes selected, which is this, and this. I hold on Shift on my keyboard. That's why I'm selecting this. So all this part of the hair, which is this one. This one is this one. Right, every damn thing here. Okay, I'm just going to add all these stuffs like so. I don't need this to be selected. No, I select that. Select this one, this one, this one, this one. This. Okay. Probably all this right here. Yeah. So now once you're done with the selection, I'm gonna add a little bit, make this a little bit bigger by one, and I'll click on this drop down menu of the stroke and I'll click on this. Now what this does, it turns my stuff into my lines into a sharp edge line. So let me just go back to the one the same. Yeah, this is pretty cool. Turn the lines into a sharp edge line, as you can see. The ones that you don't add, you can go back and redo those stuff like this and this. We need that to come down here and do that. Yeah, that's pretty cool. Now right here, I'm going to do the same thing. Maybe it's a little bit bigger. Now just allow it to 1% is okay. Yeah, so that's pretty cool. So right here, I have these two. Alright, okay, quickly go down here and do that. So now this is pretty cool. Okay, this is okay for me, and you can go ahead and do more that is if you really want to, but this is really okay for me. I'm okay with all these steps that I have done so far. So I'm just gonna do the same thing right here. Now if you're making use of a desktop where you know your light is not really stable, you don't really want to go ahead and save because you don't want to lose any work. This is not the right time to lose any work or unsave work. Alright, just quickly go through all this stuff. Right, I'm okay with this. And the last one, I'm pretty okay with this. So I'm looking this stuff from my second screen right now. Okay, so now this is really cool. What next I'm gonna do, I'm gonna grab a pencil, which is right here. Grab a pencil and I'll click, and now I'm gonna create a line just like that. Hit escape on my keyboard to deselect that, grab the move to, and just quickly do something like this and make it a little bit bigger, just like so. Right, so now I want to select everything and move it into place so my camera is properly. Actually, this is what I have. I can move it down, but I can do that later on. So let me see. I can just highlight everything right now. I'm gonna set it this, and I'm gonna just like on the hard extra strip to this to make it a little bit thick. And I'm okay with this. Yeah, this is too thick, and I'm really okay with that. I'm gonna select that again. I set up that one. I'm gonna do that and do this dot and add a little bit of just 1%. Alright, this is pretty okay.
Through the wastelands, through the highways, till my shadow turns to sun.